Body Ventura, Paul, he's your opponent tonight. What do you make of him?
Gene, I was in the VFW back home. A guy comes up to me and says, you know what that Jesse Ventura reminds me of? I says, no, what? He says, a nest full of baby robins. They're all moths and they're full of...
feathers.
Full of feathers, that's right. Jesse Ventura, you're a challenge. When I was challenged in weightlifting, I became champion. You're my next challenge.
All right, Lee Otis and Bobby Krieger, Steve Olsonowski, we're wishing you the best of luck. Just before we went on the air tonight, Bobby Duncombe, he's a big man.
That's right, Gene. Summer's coming. It's time to get out to the golf course. It's time when the challenges and the competition gets tough and the challenges are met. And tomorrow...
thank you very much, the all-time greats. Now, how you can come in here strutting and smiling, Jesse Ventura, after what you just have done. They had to haul out Dick Reynolds. Totally uncalled for, my friend. Totally.
Don't you voice any opinions out here to me, little man. You just hold the microphone and let me do my rapping, you understand? That's just the start. Tonight, Paul Ellerat, get ready, brother, because it's the irresistible force of Paul Ellerat against the immovable object of the body, Jesse Ventura. Take a look at that, huh? Take a look at that.
I'll give you that.
I'm bigger than him. I'm stronger than Ellerat. I've got everything going, and most of all, I'm more beautiful than Ellerat.
Did you pick the hat up here in town, Jesse?
The hat's from California, little man, and don't talk about the hat. Let's talk about Ellerat. Get ready, brother, because tonight is the night.
You better believe
I'm gonna
it
beat
is.
A man
it
tonight.
Paul,
I'm going to beat him worse than
there
I beat this dude
it.
Here this afternoon,
forget
and don't
it.
Cut me off
we're
out here,
out of time.
Man.
We're out of time.
Yeah.
Forget it. Jesse, the Body Ventura. Holy cow. I have been informed by promoter Wally Carbo, after the challenge of Jesse the Body Ventura in a weightlift exhibition, that match will also take place on July the 15th. And Paul, for the benefit of myself and the fans watching television this morning, just exactly what is a deadlift?
Well, Gene, I'd like to explain. First, I'd like to say, you know, you're the best commentator I've ever seen.
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Yeah, very good. The deadlift, Gene, is the strength lifts of all lifts. We start out with the weight on the floor. We don't lift it from racks. We don't lift it from anything. We start out with the weight on the floor, and it's how much can you lift? How much can you pick up?
All right, now that is standing upright, Paul.
That's right.
Okay, probably you can demonstrate. If our cameraman can get a shot, Paul, let's start from the first initial move and your grips on the bar. Okay. No weights, obviously, on this bar, but I'm right. certain that you can demonstrate exactly what transpired.
First thing we do is we reverse the grips because we can't hang on to this much weight like this. Start out and the weight's going to be on the ground. We're going to start out down in here in the set position, and we're going to stand up, and we're going to pick it up like that. And brother, he better be ready.
All right, now, for the record, Paul, in the 220-pound class, you set a record at 745 1/4 pounds in the deadlift.
That's true, Gene. This is the challenge of my life, to lift against a man who weighs 30 pounds more than me. It's like a heavyweight boxer fighting a middleweight. And I'm going to have my work cut out for me, Gene.
All right, Paul Ellering, thank you very much. A very modest young man. Here is a gentleman who is not quite so modest.
Here comes Mr. Modesty Jack right here. The stage is set. The yellow rat has taken the cheese.
Well,
did you see out here tonight? I beat two men. I beat two of them. Next time I might go after three. But let's get on to the yellow rat and this weightlifting. I seen the man out here straining with the bar that he had here with nothing on it.
Now, come on, Jesse. That's an exaggeration
now,
on your part.
Now, Jack, let's move on. Let's talk about his 745 1/4. Excuse me.
Well,
listen to this. What was the quarter? A hamburger with cheese?
Oh, come on now, Jesse.
Well, let's find out, Ellerat, because I'm going to tell you right now, the advantage is in my favor, because nobody knows what I can do. Isn't that right? Well, no one knows what I can lift, what the body can lift. And the body's ready. The body's going to pull. I can't believe it. Oh, talk to me. You know, the secret to weightlifting is communication between you and your muscles. Talk to me, brother.
Oh, my.
Talk to
me. Isn't this a bit?
Yes.
Oh, come on.
Tell me what you're going
to
do.
Fans, we'll get you back to the action after this. Oh, you're too much.
Yes.
I don't mind, will you?
Gilbert rammed his head against the post. Jesse, the body, doesn't bother you at all.
It doesn't bother me at all, Jack. And I want to know something right now. Why do you wear them sunglasses? You want to look like the body, don't you? Deep down inside, little man, you want to look like me. That's why you wear them. Ellerat, you sound like Jimmy Swaggart out here. You're going to need some help. You're going to have to believe. You're going to have to believe and believe. And you know what? Tomorrow's Sunday. Tomorrow's Sunday, Rat.
Tonight's the night.
I'm so fired up, I don't even know what day it is. All I know is the weights are going to come, little man, and I'm going to pull them, and I'm going to destroy this world record holder. And when it's all said and done, they're going to call me the new world record holder. I'm going to set a world record tomorrow night. So all you weightlifters out there, you come down there and you watch the body set a new world's record.
Jesse, the body, and Paul Ellering, who will win that dead weightlifting contest tonight at the Minneapolis Auditorium?
Both of these men, of course, have been challenging each other for a long time, and here is where they separate the wheat from the chaff. On the left is Paul Ellering, and of course, he has the weightlifting belt around his waist. The man who's prancing in the background there is Jesse the Body Ventura. They have already, each of them, have successfully lifted 480 pounds. Now, they are using an Olympic bar. The bar itself weighs 45 pounds, and it's going to be Paul Ellering's turn right now, I think. He looks very contemplative about this. He's concentrating. They're going to have to lift 560 pounds. And Jesse, I think, let's see now, Paul concentrating, tightens the belt. So he doesn't tear everything loose. Plants his feet very firmly, gets his balance. Concentrating all the while. He has not taken the official grasp right at the moment. Now, there's a last bit of concentration. And he reaches down for the lift. And lifting it up. He has to get it up in the locked position, the shoulders back. And 560 pounds, Paul Ellering, successfully lifting. Jesse the Body Ventura can't believe it. He does not like that at all. He didn't think that Ellering can do it. Paul looks very confident. The ring announcer now, something about Jesse is asking, making a request here. I can't pick up on it. Al DeRusha, the ring announcer, you might be able to hear some of his comments. Now Jesse is asking for 50 pounds to be removed. Now Jesse must lift this 560 pounds or lose the deadlift contest. Protesting to the referee, Joe Snyder. Jesse realizing that the die is cast. Looking around, trying to concentrate. Eyeing the bar. His feet. Notice that. Now he steps back. One hand is palm up, the other hand is palm over. That's the way they handle it in the deadlift contest. Paul Ellering, having held the NCAA deadlift contest at 745 and a quarter pounds when he was at the University of South Dakota at Brookings. Jesse the Body Ventura again. Now planting his feet. They must get that balance properly. Must be proper, I should say. Too much weight on one side or the other, of course, will defeat the lift. Concentrating. Now, Jesse, up, up, up. Shoulders back and locked. A signal by Joe Snyder, and Jesse successfully lift. And there it is. He's very confident. He's mighty pleased. And Jesse the Body Ventura has lifted that also. We'll return to the action in just a moment after we pause for this message of the deadlift contest between Jesse the Body Ventura on the right of the screen and Paul Ellering on the left. And they have just both successfully completed lifting 560 pounds. And you just heard Paul Ellering call for the next weight of 700 pounds. 700 pounds. That's like lifting a grand piano all by yourself. But other weights compare to 700 pounds. Pile seven 100-pound sacks on top of each other and try lifting that. But this is dead weight, dead, solid, cast iron. And now they are adding the weights. Now Jesse, the body Ventura, a little apprehensive. He's watching. And the reason they have so many men there is to check and be sure the weight count is accurate on both ends so that the bar is not heavily weighted on one end and cause injury. Now listen, Ventura is protesting. He wanted some. He doesn't want 700 pounds, but they're going to have to. All right, now I'll give it to you right now. Paul Ellering, it was his choice to call for the weight. He called for 700 pounds. And if he can lift it and Jesse the body can't, well, then Paul Ellering would be the winner. But Paul feels very confident he can do it. Now, the other end, the weights being added to the other end, the locks being put on so that those weights don't slip off. Boy, oh boy. They get some chalk in their hands. Tremendous. They have to be tremendous weight on those hands themselves, on the palms. And of course, you can tear the skin, tear those hands apart. Just think, 700 pounds. Dead weight on two hands, five fingers. Actually, one hand is placed underneath the bar palm up, the other hand is put over the bar palm down, and then the grip is made in that fashion. Jesse the body Ventura is asking for the crowd to be quiet so he can concentrate, and he does not like the idea that Ellering has put him to the wall with a 700-pound call. He'd like the crowd to be quiet. To get much sympathy from the crowd or much cooperation. He says, I can't concentrate. I have to be able to concentrate to lift that much weight or even to attempt it. Joe Snyder said, all right, get to it. There's the right hand going under in this case. Now you ask for more quiet. Complaining to Aldarusha, the ring announcer, that he's got to have quiet. Jesse will, of course, attempt this weight lift first. 700 pounds. Think about that one. Looking at it, what do you suppose is going through his mind right now? Now he's distracted again. Going up, planting his feet. Palm under, palm over, the grip. He can't do it. He says, I got to have it quiet. I don't even want to attempt it. Those muscles are cooling down in between those lifts. Joe Snyder saying, all right, either you do it, or Ellering is declared the winner. I think Paul is asking the crowd in the spirit of good sportsmanship to be quiet, to allow Ventura to concentrate. Anxious to see who will win this one. Now, concentrating again. A tremendous amount of concentration. You watch the Olympic lifts, you'll see the men very serious about their work, concentrating for many moments. Planting the feet. Will he do it this time? Now, if should... Well, let's take a look here. Let's wait. All right, getting his feet set. 700 pounds. All right, there's the attempt at the lift up. It goes up and goes. Oh, and he can't do it. He couldn't bring it up to the full stance. The locked shoulders in the back position. He did not make it. But now let me remind you of something right here. He claims that he couldn't hack it. Something about his back. Now, Paul Ellering must lift 700 pounds. Jesse missed, but Paul must make the lift. And in the locked position with the shoulders back to win. I think Jesse just said, if I can't lift it, you can't lift it, Ellerat. Tightening the belt now, Paul Ellering thinking about it. Deliberate, strides over. Concentration. What do you suppose is going through Paul Ellering's mind? Maybe a bit of a prayer, who knows? Really Connors. Look at this young man. Look at this body. The
work at the concentration. Like he's almost stalking that bar. He steps up to it. One foot a little bit ahead of the other. Some will attempt to lift with their feet parallel. Paul's right hand goes over the bar and the left hand under the bar. It's an absolute opposite grip from Jesse the Body Ventura. All right, goes down again, 700 pounds. Well, he's going to change his stance just a little bit. Didn't like the feel of it. All right, grabbing the bar, gripping it. It won't slip, that's the reason for the opposite palms. All right, here goes. Trying to get it up off the ground, up, up. There's where Ventura lost it. That Paul going up even higher, higher, higher yet. And the shoulders are back. The count, and there it is. Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, you thought that when Paul Ellering lifted that 700 pounds, frustration, Jesse the Body Ventura threw a handful of palm chalk at Paul Ellering in the face, and that stuff burned. That's very caustic. And now he goes to work on him. Paul Ellering defeating Jesse the Body Ventura at 700 pounds. Takes several people to hold Ventura back. Weights. I hope he's not injured. Apparently, there is some serious injury to Paul Ellering. He may be out. I'll tell you. I think that probably the injury came about when Paul still had the weight in the air. I don't know. I can't anticipate. They're calling for a stretcher. Jesse the Body Ventura claiming a victory, while Paul Ellering seems to be totally out of it. I do not have the slightest idea what to anticipate from here. They've got a stretcher in there now. And I'm sure Paul must have ruptured a whole bunch of muscles or groups of muscles. That's a terrible thing, really. No need for that. None whatsoever. I think maybe Ventura just went a step too far. The straw that broke the camel's back, all the other cliches you can think of. But there's no reason for that kind of action. That is my personal opinion. I'm sure many people will agree. Well, we're going to take... Well, obviously, going to have to take him for treatment. Saw examination, obviously, before any kind of treatment. I don't know if it's his back or his legs or his, the muscles in his forearms. All right. Now, they're taking Paul out on it. There's just, as I said, no reason for that action by Jesse the Body Ventura. Now, look. Ventura going. They're going to cordon the people around him. Was the winner. I don't know. He won the battle. Maybe he lost the war, the physical body war. Who knows? See, I hope he's not.
All right, I failed to lift it, but the yellow rat was cheating. The man had grease on his legs. That is illegal. You got the rule book. Look in it. That is an illegal lift to have grease so that the bar will slide up. I stepped forward to try to point it out to the referee, and he wouldn't listen to me. The man was cheating on the lift. He could have never did it any other way.
Well, I'll tell you what, Jesse, that's your opinion and your side of the story. I don't necessarily agree with it.
You never agree with me. You're always biased against me. You, the promotion, everything is biased against me. I've had it.
All right, Stevens.